What's up guys, the Bobcat here, and welcome back to Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. Last time, we got the keys we needed to go to the DLC, and that's pretty much it. We died. Once. Twice, I think, maybe? No, just once. Ooh, the Berserker Blade. I talked about that. I would really like to get hold of it, but I've never been able to. We also killed a bunch of lizards, and got to this area here. I don't think I'm missing any items bar the one just there, so let's go and grab that one. And then we can progress somewhere. What is it? Twinkling Titanite times 2 and a Fragrant Branch of Yore. Very nice. Okay, Edge Feather out. So I think today we are going to start the DLC. Still got to fight the Edge Dragon. The ancient dragon. Oh, I don't want to fight that dragon, it's so painful. Oh, I know that sword. It's the sword you get from the boss of the Crown of the Ivory King. You know what? I said I was going to do it. Let's head back to the Bridge Threshold, turn in the petrified egg, then go to the ancient dragon and kill the ancient dragon. And in fact, I might join up with the Dragon Covenant, because I've never done it before. Although, we would technically be killing our leader, but... Actually, where'd you get the dragon weapons from? I mean, we saw them on the way up, they had this sword and such. Can we walk on this? No, we can't. We die horribly. Okay, bonfire. Continue to not block me. But, as I was saying... put on. Yes, you are. I don't know where you get the dragon weapons from, but apparently they're really good. Well, I say apparently. All of the weapons are technically good, if you know how to use them correctly. Oh, I forgot as well. We did this ages ago, but we turned off the fire to this area. So we can actually loot this area now. You'll ignore the guy. The iron key! That was the key we needed. In the last part, I was hanging around a door, like banging on it, getting really annoyed. I remembered where the door went, so it wasn't too big a deal. But, yeah, that's the key we needed. So that's where the iron key is. Good to know. Future reference. Okay. Now then, to turn the petrified egg into, what's it called? I forget what it's called.
What is that? A petrified egg from the shrine. Fantastic. Might you give it to me? I'm fascinated by it. I'm begging you.
Sure, we don't need it.
Oh, very kind of you. This thing is amazing. Could it be a dragon egg? Oh, I feel invigorated just by holding it. You've quite a...
So now we can enter the Dragon Covenant. This is what incense does, by the way. I haven't used it at all. It's probably actually best for like Homeward, actually. But, what was it? Buy item. Still the same stuff. We should probably buy the carvings now that we have enough. They're always fun. Nothing else. Don't want to enter the covenant. Okay, we got that part out of the way. Now then. Next place. Is going to be what? Probably Shulva. Still got to defeat Vendrick. Actually, I'd like to defeat Vendrick first. So you know what, let's give it a go. Let's go after Vendrick. I'm probably going to get brutally murdered because Vendrick is nothing to sneeze at. He is really powerful. Yeah, he's under ditch. Even though he's technically dead. So, we'll see how it goes. I do remember fighting him though once or twice before. So perhaps I will do just fine. We'll have to see. We'll see how it goes. Besides, I wonder if he's got any dialogue, because we can speak to him now that we have the Ashen Mist Heart. But we have to kill him first. What I want to put on is the Soldier's Ring, or the Ring of Iron Protection, because I don't feel safe. And we're just going to run. Why not? We'll be stupid. Could possibly go wrong. Oh dear. There goes the bell. Yep, they're angry. Excuse me, coming through. I don't know how far they'll chase us, but hopefully they'll stop at the this door here, with any luck. Hello, Vendrick. So we have 4 of the giant souls we need. Technically we could go for a 5th one, we'll see how it goes. I'll probably get the 5th one anyway, but... ugh. 2, 3, there we go. Oh wow, 3 attacks did only that much damage. Yeah, he's tough. Let's eat some green blossom. So we got the stamina recovery we need. Oh, the delay on that swing. Yeah, you can see here, even though he's hollowed, he's pretty tough. This might take a while. How to do this? You know what? I'm going to pause the video here, and when I return, I will hopefully be at the end of defeating Vendrick. So, you may wonder what I'm doing back in the gutter. Well, the simple answer is I am sick of not having my Ring of Life protection. I died to Vendrick 2 more times, quite easily in fact, so I probably were going to want to get my 4th soul, my 5th soul actually. But for now, somewhere in here, an NPC spawns. Well, an NPC Black Phantom, that is. And we need to kill her, because around her is the ring I want. Also, there's a hidden door in here which we can use the Forgotten Key on, so I want to do that as well. So yeah, we're going through the gutter. Wonderful. Where was that door? I don't think it was over there, but it might have been. Well, we can find out. We have the Aged Feather, so I'm not really too concerned about having to do a bunch of warp effects. I'm just worried about it for the video rather than anything else. Now then, is it up here? Oh! Where is he? He's right there. Okay, Navlan. Be my guest. Thank you for the 2,000 souls. Apparently he keeps invading. Always nice to see him. Keeps on our toes. Looking for the human effigy. Okay. I don't think this door has the ring behind it, but I think it has Havel's. Ooh, this is horrible. Oh, this is absolutely disgusting. Ugh. Kill everything. Kill it all. I would say burn it, but the statues, so... burning would have no effect. Now, what is this? Havel's. That's what I thought it was. Okay, so we have Havel's now. Did we get his ring? Or do you get that somewhere else? Havel's ring anywhere? Doesn't like it. We've got Havel's set. There's Havel's. Havel's leggings. Leggings, as if hewn from a giant boulder, they offer stupendous defense, but weigh a ton. They do. The origin of the name Havel is not clear. Some say it was a warrior who wore the armour, others say it was the name of a great kingdom ruined in a barbaric war. Havel's armour is really, really good. It's just really, really heavy. Because it's, well, made from a rock, as it says. He's actually in Dark Souls 1. And he drops a really good ring. However, he likes to kill me a lot, so... that's that as well. Now, where on earth is this Black Phantom? Well, I see a glowy item over there, so that's my direction from now on. That way. Somewhere in the gutter is the Black Phantom. And where that Black Phantom is the item I want. Can that be rolled off? We'll jump just to be safe. Oh dear, that was acid. How's our equipment looking? Ooh, our dragon ring, we nearly broke. Repair powder. There you go, problem solved. Or at least helped. Don't need to worry about that dog thing, they can't climb a ladder. And how on earth do I get over to where that area is? That's the question. Because I don't travel the gutter that often, I usually just go through it and call it a day. But now I need to find that ring, so I'm not stopping this area until I found it. Okay, I see glowies. Follow the shinies. It's generally a somewhat good idea. Can we get to it from here? That looks jumpable. Silly jump, but a jump nonetheless. Now, what's it actually like? Can we get a torch on that? Let's light the torch. Well, it can be gotten onto because there's messages up there. I'm just wondering if there's an easier way. Okay, you two need to go. And that guy dropped an item in the bridge. If we got onto the area above here. Oh dear. Okay, that was rude. Also, our damage has improved significantly since we were last here. At least it seems to have, I mean, we killed him in two swings. So if we were to head up here, get rid of you. Jump from here, maybe? It's a bit of a jump. It's a very scary jump as well. And if I die, I lose all the souls I had in Vendrick's room. Not good. How on earth do you get over there? I hate mazes. It looks like there just has to be a way here. It doesn't look like there's any other way. Oh, I hate the gutter. I hate mazes, and I want my Ring of Life protection. I'm sick of not having it. It hurts not to have it. I can buy one from Felkin the Outcast, but that implies pumping our intelligence until Felkin will talk to us. Okay, that looks promising. Let's do something really stupid. Oh my god, we made it. My heart nearly stopped. Okay. This doesn't look like the area that has any promise to it, but it's a start. A start is better than nothing. Oh, thanks. Just what I wanted. Okay. So we have some form of a start. Let's continue going. Perhaps we will find a finish. Or fall into the abyss. There's a chest in there. Perhaps that be my Ring of Life protection? Oh, you cheeky statue. Now, how does one get into that little room? Does it involve the floor breaking? What's over here? Maybe a chest. Oh, I see how we get into that room. There we go. Is this it? Yes, the Ring of Soul Protection. At long last, my life is complete. Give me that Ring of Soul Protection right now. Ring of Soul Protection. It's going to cost an absolute fortune to repair, but it means we will no longer hollow when we die. Can I just hop off there or what? That doesn't work. Okay, I guess we have to jump. We also have a Black Phantom chasing us. Melinda the Butcher. Yeah. Reference to her old counterparts, the other butchers which have appeared through the games. That's perfect. What do you have? Ah! God damn, that actually made me jump. Holy god, I actually jumped out my chair then. I said chair, I'm not even in a chair. Oh god. Die. I did not think you were a mimic. Oh god. Note to self, check for mimic. At least we found the fourth one, we got the dark armour. Oh, I've got adrenaline going now. Okay. The adrenaline's pumping. Time to fight that phantom, wherever she's gone. There she is. She has a prisoner's tattoos on her head and apparently a big axe. I'm guessing the axe hurts. Although according to the wiki it's only a +3, so perhaps it's not as bad as I thought. Ooh! She dodged. That doesn't hurt too much. I don't want her going off the edge in case she drops something. Drop anything? Nope, she didn't. Okay. Deep breath. Oh my god. Just calming down from that mimic. Oh, that scared me. That scared me something fierce. I did not think that was a mimic. And then I heard the chest make a weird noise. And I thought to myself, huh, what is that? Oh no. Too slow. You don't make me jump. You go on way. Okay, so I've got on my ring. Perfect. Time to leave. Then we go back to Vendrick, get my souls back, because I'm not leaving that many behind. Not to there. There we go. I had like 100,000. Not willing to part with quite that many. But now we have our ring of lack of protection, so I feel a lot more comfortable. But I'm not sure about this, but I only think there are now, well, I think there are only now two rings of, well, life protection, the soul protection and life protection. Apparently the other two have disappeared, so there's just soul protection and the one in, and the one you buy from Felkin. So I have no idea if that's the case or not. It's just what I read before, well, when I was looking for where the ring was. Thank you, forum page for that. Apparently my souls are outside the door, which is fine by me actually. I'm happy with them being there. Okay. Now then, return to the bonfire and let's go and kill ourselves an ancient dragon. Or get killed by it. We'll have to see which one happens first. Could really do with more fire defence, all things considered. As well, our fire defence is not great. To the Dragonary, or the Dragon Shrine as it is. Hey, he's got a nice a bit of fashion souls. Now, I've only watched the Ancient Dragon be killed once before, and even then it was using magic. So, how this is gonna go? I don't know. What rings do we have on? Okay. Would like to have my covetous rings back on, but I will make do with what I have. Delay on that swing was fierce, but not too terrible. Need more arrows. Forgot to do that. Well, thankfully there ain't too many of these guys. Let's see if I can fight this guy without needing to poison him. See how much he hurts? These Drake Keepers are just horrible to fight. Some of the worst enemies. Nothing original about them. That was a mistake. Oh, I hate Drake Keepers so much. I mean, they're just reskins of the old knights from Hade. And all they have is just a rapid increase in swing speed, which is infuriatingly annoying. Well, thankfully our ring broke and saved us the trouble, so back to Majula we go. Would really like to avoid having to do all this teleporting and running around, but oops, I guess. Then to the Doors of Pharos to get to Gavlan, or get more arrows from Gavlan. How much does this ring cost to repair as well?
I knew.
It costs 14,000? Seems more expensive than I remember it being. Well, I don't remember how much it was previously, so I suppose we'll just have to deal with it and not die too often. Crichton's mask can be upgraded a bit more. This fire defence on it is not bad. Does this offer fire defence? It does. What offers the best fire defense? Well, regardless, it's about the same, but I could go with the leggings. Oh, fall launch chest piece as well. Would like to get that upgraded.
Oh.
Although I don't like to stick to just one armor set. Perhaps I will. We'll speak with Melentia, get our soul gems restocked. Soul gems. Shells crate and stuff. Life gems. Get all of them we need.
Thank you.
To Gavlan we go. Dulciferus. Here we go. 10 minutes left. Perhaps we can get through to the boss. Don't know if we'll fight it or win it, but we can get there. With any luck. Probably going to turn every single one of those Dragon Warriors hostile, which is not going to be very good, but... ugh, I'm just going to have to deal with it. There's a lot of them as well. Going through there is going to take a bit of time. Well, I don't want to fight Vendrick as I am. He's still as nasty as he used to be. Oh, really? I need to upgrade my strength some more. What did he drop? A Mastodon piece? Rusted Mastodon helm. Can we parry these guys? That was far too soon. Oh, nice. Get parried. And drop old mundane stone. I don't think I've ever used mundane stone. Now then, let's go see Gavlan. Get our soul or poison arrows back.
You.
So at this point, as well, I might add, I believe we're approaching the end of the game. I mean, we still have a bit to do, yes, but if I'm sensible and play well, it won't take us that long. Bar the Fume Knight, and I'm not doing Ludden Zillin. Just pointing that out before anyone asks. I'm not going through Frigid Outskirts ever again. I hate that place too much to want to. Well, maybe I'll go a little bit in because it is an item I want, but I would rather never go through that area ever again. Nightmares from it. Oh, Frigid Outskirts. The, well, arguably the worst place that in any of the FromSoft games is appalling. If you watch me go through it on my, when I did the Crown of the Ivory King, you will quickly understand why I hate it so. It's just not good. It's almost as bad as the one in Broom Tower that I'm also not looking forward to going through. But probably will, because it's not as bad. It's still horrible, but it's one of the so-called co-op areas they made, which is really, really unpleasant. Okay, being silly, fighting this guy head on. Oh, I don't know how he got to that. Well, he's dead. Give me that dragon charm. If you look at these guys, you can see they're wielding these axes. I wonder how you get those. Oh, did I anchor you? Good, I didn't. Oh boy. Never fought the dragon before. I sort of know his moveset, but I think he's easier to do if you use magic. I don't have magic. I saw someone beat him easily with the use of Soul Geyser, which is something I do not have access to. Okay, you need to stop doing that. Old man getting hold of that sword. I mentioned that as we first came through here, but I really wouldn't mind. Also, I should point this out, there are summons for this fight. You can summon Vengal, and now that we've killed Melinda the Butcher, we can summon her as well. Their summon signs are here, I think, but we can't get them until we actually get the boss engaged, so... not looking forward to it. What's our fire defense at? Apparently still at 24, even though it's not. It's at 24... plus 40, plus 20, plus 22, so 60, 82, 106. Not great, I suppose. Okay, how to do this? Well, I have no idea. YOLO, I guess? He's probably just going to step on me. Here we go. 3. He doesn't actually have that much health. it run away. It's a fire breath. Where am I running? I can't even tell. Fuel. Get life gems on. Okay, that's the attack I want to bait. A lot. Probably should get some. Come on, brief fire again. Now he's going up. Run away. Okay, green blossom. Go. Life gem. Attack. Just the one, because I don't know if he's got a step attack. Get him to breathe fire again. Okay, he's going vertical. I like the music. I will point that out. Okay, do your fire breath. Good. Rock away. Get him to do his fire breath again if he will. No, he's going vertical. I think that attack used to be a lot larger. Also, does he seem to have shrunk slightly? Or is it just the perception? I think it's just the perception. I think he's just as scary as he was when you first saw him. One, two, three. Going well. If you're just stuck in this loop, I am fine with this. I'm not going to complain. Blossom time. Probably could equip, like, lightning pine resin or something, which should help. Oh, what's this? Okay, he was just moving. It's fine by me if he wants to just do that. Fire breath. Yep, fire breath. Two, three. Don't get greedy. There's no need. Fire breath. No, he's going vertical. Lightning pine resin. We have none. So, charcoal blue. Oh dear, this is bad. We're right in front of him and we're nowhere near him. Ooh, we're dead. Oh wow, we survived. Pop life gems like there's no tomorrow. Get up in his grill. There you go. Has that damage increased a bit? I think it might have. Do. It's going up. Life gem again. We've got 2 minutes left on this fight and half health. This might go a bit longer than I want it to. Start bursting him down a bit more. Get our green blossom ready. It's going up. Leg it away. Green blossom. Nom nom nom. Here we go. Deep breath. There we go. Attack as much as possible. Don't get greedy. Why not? That was foolish, but oh well, it paid off somewhat. We have 1 minute left. Probably can't do the fight in that time, but oh well, might have to cut this down a little bit. Might cut out the run up here. Okay. 3 more times, that's what I'm thinking. Probably could get an attack off on his head as well now that I think about it. Here he goes. Run away. Chow down on that green blossom. Through our mask, somehow. Best not to question it. There we go, get in there. Take every opportunity we can to damage in. Hey, to the face. Here he goes. We're up by a few seconds. Come on, we can do this. We can do this. I am shaking with adrenaline. One more attack. Come on, one more. Done. Ring swap. There we go. Soul of a dragon and petrified dragonbone. Holy God. We did it. I'm going to have to end this part here. Hopefully you all have enjoyed. If you have, leave a like, subscribe to see more, and I will see you all next time.